Hi! In this video, we'll set up an animated scene in Alight Motion using a number of primary and secondary animations that come together to make everything more engaging. If you would like to follow along, you can download the project packages from the link in the description. Here in our sample starter project, we already have some assets added to the timeline. At the bottom, there's a background layer and a group layer, which contains vector drawings of the character and the skateboard. If you'd like to learn more about vector drawing, please see our video on the topic. Using these assets, we are going to set up a scene that is low to the ground, focusing on the skateboard and the character crouching on it. We'll animate not only the character, but we'll also animate background elements to set the scene and add to the feeling of movement. Let's get started. The road provides perspective for the scene, and also acts as a base for the skateboard, so it'll be the first thing we create. Let's add a rectangle to our project. This will be our road. We're going to stretch out the points a bit. Let's tap on this menu and select Convert to Outline. This will give us access to the Edit Points panel. We can now edit the rectangle like a vector drawing. Let's move the upper points closer to each other, and let's move the bottom ones further apart. If you'd like to learn more about working with vector drawings, please see our video on the topic. Now, let's rotate our layer into the screen so that it looks more like a road. Let's add the flip layer effect with standard settings. Change the axis to 90 degrees, and then adjust the angle until it looks like a road. We'll name this layer Road. Finally, let's extend the duration of the road layer to the length of the project, and also go to Color and Fill to change the color to something more suitable. Now that we have the road in place, let's create and animate some road stripes. Let's add a rectangle to the project, adjust its length, width, and color to what you see here. We'll also increase the duration of the layer to the length of the project. We want to create multiple copies of this road stripe along a straight line, just like on a real road. To do this, let's create a vector drawing and place one point at the top of the preview and one at the bottom. Let's enable the stroke and change the color to something that is easily visible. Move the line layer below the rectangle layer on the timeline. Now, we can tap the rectangle layer and add the effect Repeat Along Path with standard settings. This will create a number of copies of the rectangle along the line we just created. We've created too many copies, so let's reduce the amount until they no longer overlap. We can add some space between them by making the line longer in Edit Points. At this point, we can head back to the Repeat Along Path effect on the rectangle and animate the phase to make the lines look like they're moving. At the beginning of the layer, add a phase keyframe. And then at the end of the layer, increase phase to a multiple of 100. This will allow the lines to loop correctly. If we play back the animation, we can see the stripes are moving up on the screen. Let's hide the line layer, because we don't need to see it in our animation, and group the two layers to make them easier to work with. Let's rename the group Stripes. To make the stripes fit on the road, tap the road layer, tap Effects, tap the Overflow menu, and choose Copy Effects. Leave and tap the group. Tap Effects, tap the Overflow menu, and then tap Paste Effects. We can take some time to tweak the stripes at this point if they don't match up with the road perfectly. If we play this back, we now have our road animation. Now that we have our road set at the perspective we want, let's animate our character and the skateboard. We'll animate the whole group to make them move back and forth on the road. And then we'll go inside the group and animate some pieces to make the movement more believable. To start, tap on the group, then move and transform, and position the group on the left side of the road. We'll add a position keyframe at the beginning and the end of our project to set up a loop animation. Let's then move forward on the timeline, and using the control pad in Move and Transform, let's move the character to the right. A new position keyframe has been added automatically. Let's say we'd like them to stay on that side of the road for a while. Let's place the playhead just one frame ahead and add a keyframe on the position property, and then long press on this keyframe and move it to where we'd like them to start coming back. Let's add some easing to smooth out the movement at the beginning and the end of the animation. If we play the animation, you can see that the character moves to the right, stays for some time, and moves back. Let's take note of the keyframe times. We'll be using them again later. Let's now animate the skateboard itself. Let's tap the original group layer and tap Edit Group to see all of the character and skateboard layers. Let's look for the layer for the main body of the skateboard. We're just going to rotate this slightly to mimic how leaning works on a real skateboard. Tap Move and Transform, and then select Rotation. Add a rotation keyframe at the beginning and end of the layer so we can set up a loop like before. Create keyframes at the times we used before, and make the skateboard rotate clockwise. Hold, and then rotate back to zero. Let's add easing to the rotation to make it feel smoother. If we leave the group, already our animation looks more believable. From this point, you can take some time to add the same rotation animation to the legs and feet in the same way. By doing this, it gives the feeling that the foot is controlling the skateboard movement. Now let's add some animation to the wheels. On each of the wheel layers, we will add the noise effect from the procedural category. We don't need to change any of the settings because this effect animates automatically. If we exit and play our project from the beginning, we can see that the noise helps make the wheels look like they're in motion. Let's add some more secondary animation to bring more life to this scene. We already have our main animation completed, but adding wired earphones moving in the wind will help sell it more. Our earphones are just a simple open vector shape. We have used some simple keyframe animation on the points of the shape, which gives the feeling of them blowing in the wind. To learn more about vector point animation, please refer to our video on the topic. Try to recreate the blowing animation you see on screen. Don't worry about being exact or even close. If your wire is moving quickly and violently enough, it'll be believable. It never hurts to add more detail. Let's add some trees flying by at the side of the road. In the project, we already have a group layer with trees made of circles and rectangles. And each of the trees have simple position and scale animation on them, so they flow from left to right, following the side of the road. As the tree moves to the right, it also scales down and disappears. You can tweak this animation if it doesn't match your roadside. To repeat this animation, we can create multiple copies of the tree animation layer and spread them along the length of the project. Finally, group all the trees into a single group, and then duplicate it, and then flip it horizontally to get the same animation on the other side of the road. We now have our completed scene. Did you create a similar scene or any other scene? If so, please feel free to show us your creations by using the hashtag AMSceneAnimation. If you have any questions, please make sure to ask in the comments. We'll do our best to help in any way we can.